Representing American Top Team and South Miami Sports Performance, Miami, Florida.
And he, oh, what a liver shot.
Jorge. Game first to work.
Jorge Gambred Masvidal. I am currently 27 years old.
Dude, what I got going on, man? Today's ass kicking day, man.
Get the stuff ready to kick some ass. That's all it is.
My little instruments of war.
Call me, because it's what I want to eat today.
Don't want anybody telling me to eat. I'm dieting for a while already. Fat. Zoom in on that bad boy.
My philosophy in dieting is do it right, seek help, you know, just don't read a book and think you can do it, you know, go out there, seek help, pay the extra money, you know, and do it right, you know. Not everybody could eat McDonald's like me and go compete, you know.
I got a long day, I need the protein. Peanut butter, good source of protein. A lot of people probably ain't even seen me. Peanut butter oil. Got that Modern Warfare 3. Birthday just passed. I got that new Xbox. These are the good type action.
What that trunk looks like? Smelly.
I was born right here in this beautiful city, Miami, Florida. What do I love about my city? The women, the food. What do I hate? The traffic, the 1 million idiots that live in this city. There's not enough tape to discuss all my dislikes, but at the end of the day, this is my home and I love it and I would've moved. I stay up in Coconut Creek anywhere from 2 to 4 days a week, you know. I drive back down to Miami, I got a family, I gotta see my kids, spend time with them. So I drive back as much as I can, you know, but around 4 times a week.
It's been great, man. Everything is on track. I don't hang out with no bums.
Well, I started training with Cam about 3.5 years ago, 4 years ago, and he got into some trouble, so he hadn't been gone for a year, and that was like a real damn time because though I still had great wrestling partners, I didn't have like somebody like Cam, you know, that was around my same size. They competed at a high level, you know. Cammy really helped further my game tremendously. The practices he puts us through are great, you know. It's just it's great to have a guy like Cammy in there, you know.
This is my boy Rashad, future motherfucking champion. Good kid, man.
Hey, fuck you, man! Hey, fuck you, man!
That means all I remember is the last game. You may have a 10-0 record, but if we're in the world title fight, I'm being
the world title fight.
Are you high as fuck on that?
I made the world title fight. I said, this is the last game, baby. You better give me your all. From what I can see, that you came in today delusional. That's all I can see.
Who won more games?
Who won the last game?
Who won more games?
Oh, I didn't know we were keeping track. That's the biggest thing. I didn't know we were keeping track.
Oh, no. The excuses are coming out already.
I got some new partners we've had already for a while. Nathan Coy, Kobe Covington, Bubba Jenkins, Scott Garrett, you know. All solid wrestlers. They got great, solid wrestling backgrounds. And I just love it, you know. I've always loved wrestling. I'm glad to have some high-level guys like that in the room. Those guys beat my butt up every single day, you know. If I just get to a single, like, I'm happy, you know. Because the guys are so much better than me in wrestling, and I love that, you know.
Grab my leg, you go live. I back him up with your punches. Get set, go!
In training, the coaches are scared to push the athletes because the athletes might not want to come back or whatever it is. It's just, you go to a lot of practice and sometimes the trainers themselves are like, they let like the athletes run the practice, not with Cammy. He tells you what you're going to do and how you're going to do and how many of it you're going to do, you know. So definitely Cammy's a huge influence in my life. everything to me. I mean, you know, it's what I do every day, what I've been doing every day for the last, like, past 10 years. Training, getting up, training, eating, training, going to sleep, training. You know, it's just an ongoing process, and, you know, it's just, it's life, man, you know? People always ask me what I fight for. Obviously, I fight for money. I'm a prize fighter. I got a family to feed. I got a big family, you know, I got to take care of them. I love it, you know? When I started out fighting when I was young and I was competing in the amateur, I just wanted to be the best. That's still my number one goal in head, but I'm not going to do it for free. I got to get paid for it, you know? So people always like, you're so worried about the money? Yes, I'm worried about the money, you know? We just got out of practice, morning practice, just a lot of drilling, a lot of situations. Now we're gonna go to the crib, chill, eat some food, play a lot of video games, sleep, eat more food, play more video games, and then come back at night for the real ass-kicking session. That's a tough one, man. It's a good session right now in the morning. Maybe I get some poker instead of hit the casino, you know, that's what I wanted to do. I don't know if I got enough time between the eating and the playing of video games, but I'm gonna try to squeeze it in. I stay at the house with all the fighters, with all the new guys that we brought and all the high-level wrestlers that are there, you know. We get to train, we go back, we play video games, and we crack jokes all day long, and then we go beat the crap out of each other, and then we do it all over again, you know. Currently, out of the group, I am the best player in fucking Call of Duty 3 by far. None of those guys can touch me and know that. They can wrestle and all that shit, but they can't beat me in no Call of Duty. Oh, they swear they can. I'm always at the top, you know. I play anywhere from 2 to 4 hours a day, minimum, you know. Like on a Saturday, sometimes after I'm training, I'll go like 6-7 hours straight, you know. It's crazy, because time just goes by.
Love it. It's only $1 for all this goodness. McDonald's really has some good American values. This is asking me, like, you really eat like that? Like, yeah, man. McChicken, get all the protein you need, you know? Look how wholesome that looks.
What I love and hate about the new Modern Warfare, so far I like everything except some of the kill streaks are harder to get, you know, but I think I like everything pretty much so far, you know.
We need some sparring in now.
The funnest part of the week, man.
shoulder, all the way down, sprint back, and that's one lap. You sprint down as hard as you can, and then underwater back, and that's one lap. A total of 18, which is a mile. What's going down is he's going to work on expanding his lungs. You know, he's got to be ready for a five-round fight to win a world title, so we're going to work on his endurance, you know. Get some laps, some resistance with his cardio, and some warm up down and back, and then we're gonna work on going underwater and holding our breath and expanding it, and then coming back up and doing a real high pace workout on the way back, and then opening up our lungs and expanding them on the way back. So, you know, 5 weeks, he's gotta win that world title. So, go Gambred.
I've always wanted to swim. I just never had nobody that knew the guidelines for swimming and what to swim or how much to do it, you know. Kobe was big into swimming up, so I started doing it with Kobe. And, I had one swim and I felt real good. It felt like I'm opening up my lungs already, you know? So it was good for me.
It's actually time to go.
Let me get some of my jalapeno sauce too, dog. The jalapeno sauce.
Ballin'. I can afford it today. Ballin'.
Thanks,
man.
Hey, thanks.
I started training with Paulino Hernandez about 5-6 years ago. Just, you know, big part of my professional influence career, you know, from everything. Me and him have similar styles as far as like our counter-punching ability. We clicked since day one. Since the first time I sparred with him, he was like 38 or something. I was a young buck, like 18, 19, and I used to whoop on everybody at the gym, and they put me to go with him, and he just put an ass whooping on me without trying, effortlessly. And ever since then, I was like, wow, this guy is, you know, this guy's legit, man. That he lets me do me, you know? He didn't really like change my style too much, so I just loved it. You know, me and him, since day one we clicked and we worked well. I got a title I won at 170 way back, but that was like, it wasn't a Strikeforce title, you know? It wasn't against a ranked guy, I should say, you know? The promotion at the time, was, at least for me, pretty big, you know? But yeah, it's my first big title fight, you know? So it's another fight, it's another tough guy, you know? I don't ever, like, people like, man, it's the biggest fight of your life, just like they were telling me before. And man, to me, it's just a fight, man. It's just a tough dude in there, you know? There's gonna be more people watching, you know? It don't really bother me, you know? I don't really care. It doesn't make me or break me, you know?
You could win up to 30,000, which has happened to me like 15 or 16 different times that I'm on the way. I won like $30 the other day. I'm invested like 70. So I'm down 40.
Mark it down, 717. It's going down, world champ right there.
If I get the umbrella, I get 10 grand. And I already got the mermaid, the rooster, and the sun. If I don't fight for the next like 6 months, it's because I hit this. People just don't know where I'm at. I'm not partying with this thing, man. If I got this thing, I won't last 6 months, man.
I want to be remembered by the fans. It's simple, man. It's the greatest lightweight that ever lived. You know, I want to make my mark. I've stayed at lightweight, you know, and I think it's the most competitive division out of all divisions in any organization. I just want to go down in history as the greatest lightweight that ever walked into a cage, you know, and that's all I'm going to do.
On the planet right now, okay? Anybody that fucking beats me is a bad motherfucker. This guy fucking did it. Hey, this is like my first, in my opinion, my first legitimate loss. And this motherfucker,
man, a lot of respect, bro. Respect, a lot of respect.
Respect, you know? Man.
Anyway, ATT for real, man.
Like we said, man, ATT's bringing it home. We talked about it before, man. When we went in fucking New York, man, before this tournament even started, me, Juan Buckle, and him, we were like, yo, we're taking this shit home. We're going to be in the fucking finals. It's going to suck.
Yeah.
Hey, if we got to fight each other, we got to fight each other. Nothing but respect. We're going
gonna fucking win the tournament. ATT's bring the tournament
home. It is what it is, man.
We got here, yeah. ATT's bring the fucking tournament home, and we're gonna fucking get that belt. What? Sorry, man.
Yo.
Sorry, bro. Hey, man, you got good credentials, and I respect you as a fighter, but
we are, man.
Motherfuckers got right hand that are gonna fucking
go. Got a bend. Oh.
Thanks, man. It's out, bro. All right, bro.